Welcome to two examples of solving linear equations in one variable. When solving an equation in one variable, the goal is to find the value of the variable that satisfies the equation or that makes the equation true. To do this, we want to isolate the variable on one side of the equation. So looking at this first equation, notice how we have two variable terms, but they're both on the left side, which means to solve this equation, we want the equation to be in the form of x equals some value, where this value here would be our solution. The first step is to see if we can simplify either the left side or right side of the equation. And again, because the left side has two like terms or two x terms, we can combine these two terms. 9x minus 6x is equal to 3x. Therefore, the equation simplifies to 3x minus 17 equals negative 42. For the next step, we want to isolate the variable term, or in this case 3x, which means we want to undo minus 17, and the opposite operation of subtraction is addition. So to undo the minus 17, we'll add 17 to both sides of the equation. We add 17 to both sides to maintain equality. Notice here we have negative 17 plus 17, that's 0. So the left side is now 3x. And the right side is negative 42 plus 17, which is equal to negative 25. Now looking at the left side again, 3x means 3 times x. So to undo this multiplication, we'll now divide both sides of the equation by 3. 3 divided by 3 is equal to 1. So the left side is now 1x, or just x. On the right side, we have negative 25 thirds. This fraction is simplified because 25 and 3 don't share any common factors other than 1. Therefore, this is our solution in simplest form. But just in case you are asked to convert the improper fraction to a mixed number, let's review this process. Notice how the mixed number would also be negative. So if we ignore the negative for a moment, we would divide 25 by 3 to find the mixed number. There are 8 3's in 25, since 8 times 3 is 24. Subtract, we have a remainder of 1. This tells us that negative 25 thirds is equal to a negative mixed number. It would be negative 8 and 1 third, the remainder over the divisor. But for our class, we do want to leave it as a simplified improper fraction. Now let's take a look at our second example. The difference here is, notice how both variable terms are on the right side this time, which means to solve the equation, we want the equation to be in the form of some number equals x, where this number here would be our solution. Again, the first step is to simplify either side. Notice how we have two like terms on the right side. We have negative 7x plus 3x, which would give us negative 4x. So now we have negative 48 equals negative 4x plus 42. For the next step, we want to isolate the variable term on the right side. So we want to undo this addition, or perform the opposite operation on both sides. Well, the opposite of plus 42 would be minus 42. So now we'll subtract 42 on both sides of the equation. Notice plus 42 minus 42 is 0. So on the left side, we have negative 48 minus 42. That's negative 90. Equals, on the right side, we have negative 4x. We need to be a little careful here. On the right side, negative 4x means negative 4 times x. And therefore, to isolate x, we want to divide both sides by negative 4. On the left side, a negative divided by a negative is positive. So we have positive 9/4 equals negative 4 divided by negative 4 is 1. So we have 1x, or just x. So this is our solution, but this fraction is not simplified. 90 and 4 do share a common factor of 2. So we'll divide both the numerator and denominator by 2 to simplify this fraction. Let's also change the order of this. We can write this as x equals, and then 90 divided by 2 is 45, and 4 divided by 2 is 2. So our solution is 45/2, which is simplified. Again, even though it is an improper fraction, it is our solution. But let's also show converting 45/2 to a mixed number. We would have 45 divided by 2. There are 2 2's in 4. 2 times 2 is 4. Subtract, that's 0. Bring down the 5. There are 2 2's in 5. 2 times 2 again is 4. Subtract, we have a remainder of 1. So 45 halves is equal to 22 and 1 half, the remainder over the divisor. But again, what we'll find is, as we go further and further in math, leaving our solutions as improper fractions is just fine, as long as it's simplified completely. I hope you found this helpful.